I originally didn't want to review Earth Final Conflict. I have a love-hate relationship with the show. The concept that Gene Roddenberry came up with for Battleground Earth was a nice change to stories we get when aliens come to Earth. It's usually just, there they are, bad guys. They gotta get blown up. We have the Cylons who kill human colonies, Darkseid conquers everything he wants, the Independence Day aliens blow up key locations. It's mostly a blank evil threat. EFC went in the other direction, in the beginning at least. The premise, a few years have passed on Earth, an alien race called the Talons, some people call them the Companions, they're a benevolent race that helped advance our technology, plus kind of pull the Star Trek, improving our quality of life. They appeared truthful on the outside. There's Da'an, the show's main Talon character. He's the one who's most level-headed when it comes to the planet's politics. He mainly serves as a bridge between humans and his people. A lot of Talons can't or won't understand humans, zo'or being the most vocal. Behind the scenes, both of them argue, one in favor of humans being seen as equals, the other wants to overthrow the planet. So they duke it out, underhand tactics, or I like to call it, lawyer bullcrap. To help show the planet they have good faith, they will pick accomplished humans to work alongside the Talons. But they aren't just a secret service. When you're picked for this honor, the person is given a CVI. It's basically a living symbiote. It allows the human some control over Talon tech and even a rudimentary psychic link. Plus, it doubles as an energy weapon. What they didn't say is it solely affects the person's judgment. There were two picked. William Boone, the show's main protag, and Ronald Sandoval, the main human baddie. Boone didn't really know what was going on. He has a lot of questions toward the Companions. He keeps an open mind when a resistance force contacts him, showing things that didn't make sense to what the Talons were doing. He was stuck between the two sides. On one hand, there's things going on that he can't deny. On the other, he sees Da'an. Da'an is generally trying to keep the world at peace. Sandoval doesn't care. He blindly follows the Talons without question. His CVI has taken control of him. He's had it for several years at this point. I like this subtle good versus evil plot. It wasn't cut and dry. You had actions done by Da'an where you're like, oh cool, the Talons are nice people. But then something else happens that makes you question it. There were other humans helping out the Companions, like Lily Marquette being a big one. She's one of their pilots. She and Boone were why Da'an is so adamant that humans are equal to Talons. He could see Boone challenge him in debates, not lashing out in anger. So Da'an became close to Boone, trusted his judgment, even when it went against his people. This made Boone a threat. Marquette was around the Talons for years. She knew how to use their stuff, but was not an official protector. No were. Season 1's filled with a lot of plot. Each bit connects to the next layer of the story. It never felt to overwhelm because season 1 took their time to build up Da'an versus Or, Boone establishing his place as protector. There are some episodes that are slow that you can't avoid. Everything gets put on the table. Boone finds out that Talons have visited Earth before in secret, where one of them experimented on humans, either giving them psychic abilities or using offspring to combine DNA. This was because some Talons wanted to help humans from their people's threat, giving more proof to the resistance. We also find out the Talons have been in wars with other alien species. Hajel, who's a chimera, he was shunned because of his power of assuming the forms of others. So you have cover-ups, events, and people going missing for unknown reasons, Talons like zo'or going against their own people. It's like a giant version of X-Files cover-ups. Even Da'an doesn't know what's going on. We get to learn about why Boone goes so far into gaining Da'an's trust and why he also sides with the Resistance. Originally, he was asked to be a protector. He said no. Magically, his wife is killed the next day. Boone was the real hero. I think they wanted Boone to join them as an example, be filled with grief so that Da'an would see humans as just animals. But it blew up in their face. So zo'or took advantage of the Chimera situation. More and more of those events in the past started getting connected to the Talons. This convinced Boone. He's now stuck. He knows the Talons are not genuine, but you have Da'an. What the hell does he do? Hajel breaks into the embassy, impregnates another protector, and makes the situation worse. Hajel gets killed off, with Boone getting caught up and critically injured. The resistance takes the raped woman. Talons have no idea it happened. The Talons offer their care to Boone. Don is confused with all that happened. We're all confused, but zo'or pulls something unexpected. We see Boone get vaporized in the healing tank. I went, what the freak, when that happened? They killed off the main character in the first year. This is where I started hating the show. Not because they killed Boone. You can make the character complete their story and then build on the death story-wise, like say Daniel and Stargate, I'm okay with it. They can go in this direction, that direction. It basically confirmed the Talons were the bad guys. Now I have a reason to root for the Resistance. Will Dawn defect? Not exactly. The nuances the first seasons brought us all disappears in season two. When it came back, the show became a revolving door. Actors would come and go because some would have contract disputes. So you had leads just leave after one or two seasons. This kept forcing absurd plot devices. But it wasn't just that. Some blame goes to the writers. Either the ratings were okay, but they needed them higher, so they started making more clear-cut villains. Characters would do stupid mistakes when they used to be careful. The worst affected was Sandoval. I always say Vaughn Flores is really good at playing villains, but he's good when he's not mustache twirling. His character went all over the place. He got turned into a puppet of the writers. He's just doing things and being an ass. Season 2 through 5, I'm going from memory. I didn't watch them that much. The US never released season 2 through 5 on DVD. You had to go buy them from Canada. They also stopped caring about bonus features and didn't release seasons 3 through 5 in widescreen. So with Boone dead, who replaced him? A guy named Liam Kincaid. He literally came from nowhere. Remember that woman Hajel raped? The child was born, and for some reason, a child coming from a race that can change their shape gets the ability to rapidly age to an adult, then conveniently stops, while also him having powers. Yeah, that makes sense, right? Gets worse. To fix the show's slowness, they decided to throw a million plot points everywhere. Back in season one, a probe crash landed on Earth. No one knew where it came from. It was left unresolved till now. The woman who gave birth to Kincaid, she had her memory erased by the Resistance, so they didn't get information on Liam, and she went back to the Talons. Her fiance was actually from that unknown probe, which was sent by another alien race called the Dridians. The probe was a Trojan horse. This fake human went after the leader of the Talon Synod, almost killed Da'an. Liam saves his life, so Kincaid was picked to be Da'an's new protector. Kincaid stayed a part of the Resistance, although he didn't like following orders. Zo'or, the prick Talon going behind Da'an's back, became the new leader, with Sandoval becoming his main protector. Things go further down the hole. The Dridians think humans have teamed up with the Talons, they are now targets, so the story goes off in this direction where Zo'or wants to use humans as experiments, giving them psychic powers or being super soldiers. This then makes the Resistance Force experiment on people as well. This blows up in their face, causing Da'an to get separated from the commonality. Think the Borg Collective, the Talons can connect to this psychic plane. While this, the Talons go insane. This starts causing others to overthrow Zo'or, like a new character called Lazarus. He, you know, recruited Augur. He's the Resistance main hacker guy who was doing the experiments to get him to help and start a coup on the Talon mothership. Every time some new comes on the show, they just want to take it over. It's like I'm watching Flash season 3, where they just tell a modified version of Flash season 2. Are the writers out of ideas already? How did they even get to Earth with this much betrayal within their people? No one but Da'an has any respect. This coup fails. Then they have the bright idea to introduce time travel to the show. Zo'or was using his psychic powers to manipulate humans. Liam went back in time to stop that. Even parallel universes come into play. Nothing is really coherent. They introduce conflicts to give characters something to do. You already had Zo'or be the manipulator in season one, but because he's now leader, you gotta introduce someone else to just fill his old position. Then why not just have him stay doing what he was doing? But Da'an started getting ignored. They knew they couldn't alter Da'an. He had to always stay pure, but they allowed him to find out about Kincaid's resistance connection. He didn't rat him out, but what do you do with him now? Then, out of nowhere, the resistance leader, John Doors, took advantage of the infighting of the Talons and tried to run for president. This was done so that the resistance can get a pardon. He never became president, but now they got exposed. As they gear up for the war with the Dridians, the story tries to be smart by adding in even more things. They do try to give the Dridians some backstory. Liam has to rescue Jill in one episode after a captured Dridian escaped and took her. We also get more information on the CVIs. They have a built-in imperative to serve Talons. If you can get the CVI off you, it wears off. They gave you some sort of hope for Sandoval not being a blind tool forever, but that just got thrown out. To sum up season 2, the Dridians wanted the humans to work with them against the Talons. The Resistance Force got a big head, so they became stupid. Zo'or took advantage of them, like they did, set up the Resistance by doing an assassination attempt on the President. So now, thanks to the pardon, they were captured and brought to the mothership. What did you expect would happen? Talons already showed they could manipulate and even control humans with their powers. Although they tend to ignore that in cases, Kincaid and Doors did not lead their team right. If Boone was still around, he would have stopped this. So Lily, at the last minute, tries to destroy the mothership, exposing her as a resistance member. Season 3 and 4 try to wrap up the storyline and answer what was the whole purpose of the Talons coming to Earth. You know, the big mystery since day one. Season 3 changes again. It goes into a cop mystery show. Lily is presumed dead by the Talons. She's not. Where Sandoval uses her to spy, giving her a CVI that has a camera. She also gets mutated thanks to the Dridians. Then they start copying Stargate episodes. Talon tech gets sold on the black market. People are smuggling found ancient Talon stuff like ships. So let me get this straight. Since Talons have been on Earth and they've left stuff, somehow people haven't found this alien stuff years and years ago before the Talons came out. Now all of a sudden they are. The Resistance basically falls apart. At least repercussions happen from their stupidity. Doors, who was the original Resistance leader, broke away and went to do his own thing. After he was able to bribe Zo'or, when the President found out that the people sent him the mothership was framed. Da'on himself does experiments with two twins who are Talon human hybrid. He finds out that humans are a genetic link between the Talons and the Dridians. Somehow this got lost from their records. Like, did they buy Maxtered hard drives? So we went from a conspiracy story to using humans to fight a war. Also, humans are food in season 3. Genetically modifying people, crossbreeding, it's all over the place. Then season 4 has Da'on reveals Zo'or is his child. Remember Lily and her vanishing? She was lost with the Dridians. They try to trick her, thinking she's back on Earth. They use her. She gets impregnated. So we have the cliffhanger from season 2 again. She gives birth, but don't worry about this. It'll become unimportant. Because all of the problems and screw-ups the Talons caused for the past 3 years, they decide to leave Earth before the Dridian invasion happens. All this crap because when the Talons went to war with the Dridians originally, they were actually two species together. When they were separated, the races were basically dying. In order to survive, they have to re-merge in their psychic link. That's where the humans come into play. I really didn't know what to think anymore about EFC. The twist with the Da'on and Zo'or being related threw me. It's like the Luke and Vader moment, but they waste it because it's not explored. Nothing changes between them. They still act the same way. Kincaid never really tries anything to end this crazy war. So the season 4 finale ends on a Hail Mary, where Kincaid finds a Deus Ex Machina that can restore the two species' energy, merging them together. This is where the show goes completely down the drain with what it had left. What is up with EFC and Andromeda's 5th season going to hell? Andromeda had a budget problem. You can kind of forgive it because of that. EFC just threw everything out. Forget season 1 through 4. Focus on this new story. We're bringing in the Atavis. So now the show turns into Matrix 3. That's what we end up with. When the Talons and the Dridians merged, They were basically a Tavis. Daan and Kincaid are gone, so we got a new lead again called Renee. Now Renee, she's been a secondary character since season 3. She always just hang around Kincaid and helping him out. At that point, I didn't care anymore. It went off the rails. Characters you cared about go poof. Lily's story's gone, and then you know what they do because they're desperate to get ratings? Boone comes back. They're basically like, oh, he didn't get vaporized. He was in suspended animation. Sandoval gets him out of the tank and tells him the story. Yeah, I fell for it and came back watching. Boone was barely used. He was a plot point. If you were hoping for a team up with the show's three leads, no, Kincaid pops up only in the final episode to help stop the Atavis, but that's it. In some ways, EFC tried to be like Game of Thrones. You have a deep story that progresses, the stakes get bigger. The problem was, it went out of control. Characters would do things for the plot and not be a rational choice. Others would disappear. You could see they tried to make Zo'or Smoking Man from X-Files, but they didn't know how to write a character that hides and manipulates from far away. Sandoval, they tried. They knew season 2 messed him up. They wanted you to feel something for him in season 3. They gave him a disease. He got saved. But the way he used Lily, the way he was just an errand boy, there was no going back. There was no way to save him. Once they had Daan also hide and do experiments, even though he had good intentions for his species and humans, there was nothing really left to redeem the Talons. Once he vanished in season 5, whoop-de-doo, I didn't give a crap anymore. Boone coming back was just bull. They did nothing to bring the show back to season 1's quality. They were too deep into this Atavis plot to do anything else. I need to talk about Kincaid and Renee. I don't have anything against Kincaid's character, but it felt like he just pushed the plot forward. I didn't want him to be Boone, but he didn't have the depth of Boone, and they basically forgot he's an alien. Remember, he was born from a chimera? He was basically human after a season, never used his powers. Renee, she was just who they could use. Kincaid left for the entire season, basically. She was fine, but it's like you having a Batman show, Batman disappearing, they go to Robin, you're not going to get a Batman show anymore. She fell into the same problems like Boone and Kincaid. Season 5 might as well have been a completely new series. It turned into a giant fetch quest. The Atavis did this, Renee go here and do your thing. I don't understand why they didn't just cancel it. The cast changes killed the show. Everything got screwed up each time someone left. That's where season 5 spawned from. If I had a choice of recasting the characters with new actors or do what EFC did, writing around it, I'd recast. A story narrative is more important. Imagine them doing this in Harry Potter with Dumbledore. Dropping things because someone leaves is a horrible idea. It causes a ripple effect to everything. I do like a lot of elements in seasons 2 through 4. They tried to show Talons as a desperate race, but without Boone, Lily, Daan, all those things are moved to other characters, or they're just stuck with, and this happens, and this happens, and this happens. There's no dynamic anymore. So you end up with characters changing hats. Sandoval the worst, and he's the only one who was in all 5 seasons. There's other shows out there that are worse. It just couldn't live up to itself. It would take many videos to really break down the episodes. There's a lot of things I didn't talk about. I highly recommend season 1. It's good sci-fi, it's different, it has heart, it has a plan. Just pretend season 3 through 5 didn't exist. But go watch the whole thing if you must. Yeah, EFC is really like Game of Thrones. A good first season goes down the drain in the last season. Thanks for checking out the video. Subscribe if you want to see more from me. And if you remember a movie or a show that's long been forgotten, good or bad, leave it as a suggestion below. I'm always on the lookout for obscured stuff.